Amen. In fact, we should have the opposite approach. We should take courage. Amen. We should bond together. In other words, you should tighten up your belt because you know that the word of God is true and that Jesus is soon to come. Amen. Hallelujah. So in the book of First Corinthians, chapter 15. And I want to see if Elder Reeves, I'm going to work Elder Reeves today. Thank you, Lord, because I love him. We went to assembly a few weeks back, and we had a nice time, amen, with their church anniversary. They treated Pastor Quinn well. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. And I sucked it all up. Thank you, Jesus. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, and start reading at verse 51. Yes. This is Paul talking about the rapture. Amen?
Behold, I show you a mystery.
Yes.
We shall not all sleep.
Mm-hmm.
We shall be changed.
Read that again.
Behold, I show you a mystery.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
We read
that again.
Behold,
I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep. Well, I read that again. There you have it. We shall not all sleep, but we shall what? All be changed. I heard somebody put that in a daycare. Amen. About the little babies. They said, they shall not all sleep, but they all shall be changed. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. All right, read. What's it say? In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, yes. And we shall be changed. Amen. Now, notice what Paul is saying in that 51st verse there. He said, behold. Amen. And anytime you see the word behold in the Bible, it literally means take notice. Amen. Because something is going to happen that has never happened before. Amen. When the Bible says, behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity, he wants you to take notice because it's something that's magnificent and beautiful that is rarely, rarely ever seen. Amen. So when Paul says, behold, I show you a mystery, he's literally revealing to the Holy Ghost church something that has not been revealed before. Amen? Thank you, Lord. That has not really been discussed in the scriptures. In the Old Testament, they talked about the resurrection. Amen? But in the Old Testament, they never talked about the rapture. They never talked about being changed. Only they got to talking about being changed and being raptured up in the New Testament. That's why Paul said, behold, I show you a mystery. In other words, I'm going to reveal some things unto you that has never been revealed before. Amen? Read. What does it say? Behold, I show you a what? Yes. We shall not all sleep. Now, notice what he says. We shall not all sleep. Not everybody is going to experience death. Even though all of us have appointment with death, but that appointment can be interrupted by the coming of the Lord. Amen? Hallelujah. Even come, Lord Jesus. I don't want to experience death. Amen? But if I have to, I say amen. Because to be absent from the body is to be what? Come on here, somebody. Give the Lord a praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. So he said that we shall not all sleep, but what? But everybody is going to be changed. Amen? Hallelujah. Everybody is going to be changed. I'm looking forward to that. Are you looking forward to that? Hallelujah. Looking forward to a change. Amen. A change has got to come. Amen. One thing is certain in this life is change. Things change, don't they? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. All right. Read. What verse are you in? Go to 53. Amen. Read.
Be steadfast,
unmovable, said, you are his workmanship. I'm created in Christ Jesus. I'm prepared unto every good work. Amen? Hallelujah. Nobody should be in the church without an assignment. Amen. God called you with an assignment. Amen. He called you for a purpose. He elected you, didn't he? In other words, he equipped you to do something in his church. Am I right? Hallelujah. So you want to be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. Where the people are opposing you? Should you sit down? Where the people are talking about you? Should you sit down? Where the people are not getting with you? Amen. Should you sit down? Hallelujah. Why should you sit down? You're working for the Lord. Al Peterson used to sing a song, I'm working on the building. I'm sure my face. I'm holding up the bloodstained banner of the Lord. Amen. And I'm loving him sing that song because he's 80-something years old, and then somewhere in that song he started getting happy. Yeah. Working on the building. That's the way you gotta keep your mind set. Hallelujah. I'm working on the building. I'm working on a sure foundation. Yeah, right. You gotta know what you mean is sure. Hallelujah, that's unmovable. Hey, that'll take the weight. Hallelujah. Come on here, somebody. Hallelujah. Thank you. What's this say?
Read that. Now notice,
here's the encouragement. Is the expectation. Amen. For as much as you know, we know these things. Amen. Read. What's it say?
That your labor
is not in vain. And as long as you're doing it for the Lord, it's not in vain. Amen. And Paul said that. He said, it's for as much as you know. Amen. You know these things. You ought to know these things. Amen? Because it's going to get hard. Amen? It's going to get rough.
Yeah.
And the love of many shall wax cold. Am I right? Hallelujah. Tests and trials, they're not going to get easier. Thank you, Lord. They're not going to get easier. And I'm not. Like I said, I'm not prophesying against anybody. I'm not speaking death to anybody. But it's the scripture. It's the word of the Lord. But though the tests and trials get hard, his exhortation was for us to abound. Meaning that we should get stronger. Amen? Though the tests and trials make it harder, but I'm getting stronger. You should get stronger. You should add to your faith virtue. The virtue not. The knowledge temper. The temperance patience. The patience brotherly kindness. The brotherly kindness charity. No, he said these things shall be in you and what? Avow that they shall make you neither barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen? Amen. Though the test may come, I'm growing strong. Though the test may come, you gotta grow strong. Amen? How do you grow stronger? You gotta put on the whole armor of God. Amen? Hallelujah. You gotta put on the whole armor. Amen? You got to be ready, hallelujah, for whatever may come your way. Watch and pray. Amen? I'm going to say it like this. Thank you, Holy Ghost. That whatever you got in your trip bag, you got to put it on and get it together. Amen? Pull it out. Hallelujah. You follow what I'm saying? Thank you, Lord. Use what you got. And then increase the more. Amen? Get you some more love. Get you some more peace. You follow me? Hallelujah. There's things that are happening all around us, amen, that we shouldn't be ignorant of. Am I right? Even though these things are going on, we should be focused and living for the expectation for Him to come. Amen? We're not children of the night, but we're children of the day. These things should not overtake us as a surprise. I shouldn't be surprised. Somebody, I say, hey, I go up to somebody and say, how you doing? And they cuss me out. I shouldn't be surprised about that. Huh? Because that's the time that we're living in. Amen? But I always bow and I hold my peace because I'm expecting something. I don't give up the victory because I'm expecting something. Am I right? I don't throw in the towel because I'm expecting something. Amen? Hallelujah. So Paul was encouraging the saints. He said, we're going to be changed. Angels are going to be changed. It's corruptible. It's going to put on incorruption. And this mortal is going to put on immortality. Amen? And he wants us to live with the expectation or the hope of Christ's return. Alright? Now let's see what Jesus said about it. Thank you, Lord. Go over with me to the book of St. John. St. John. Chapter 14. And, you know, I really never really thought about this scripture in this respect until the Lord started dealing with me about this particular Bible study. St. John chapter 14 and verse number 1. We know that Jesus is literally encouraging his disciples. Amen? Because he was about to die and give his life as a ransom. Alright? In fact, St. John 14, 15, 16, and 17 is literally a masterpiece. Thank you, Lord. That's what I would literally call the Lord's Prayer. Thank you, Lord. And Jesus, he knew that he was going away. So he wanted to encourage them while he was gone. Amen? And notice what he said. St. John chapter 14, verse number 1. What did he say? Now the first thing he said, don't let your heart be troubled. Hallelujah. Why would he say the heart? What's so impactful about the heart? Not your mind. Now, that's how you serve God. And if your mind is all jacked up, you're going to be all jacked up. You see people doing silly things because their mind's silly. Thank you, Lord. You see people standing strong because their mind is strong. Amen? The first thing you need to tell is your faith and your mind. If he can get your faith and your mind, he got you. What did Jesus say? I will keep thee in what? Whose mind is what? Stayed on me. You got to keep your mind stayed on your mind. He said, in the world, you're going to have tribulation. In the world, you're going to have trouble. Amen? But you, in me, you're going to have peace. He said, my peace I give unto you, not as the world gives it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. We got to keep our mind. What's the scripture say? Look up with some Bible students here. He said, guard your heart with what? All diligence. Amen. For out of it comes what? Issues of life. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. So that's why Jesus said, don't let your heart be what? Don't be troubled about me leaving. Amen. Why? Because it behooved Christ to suffer. Hallelujah. It was my mission to come here to suffer and to die. Am I right? And to give my life as a ransom for men. And then to descend into hell and preach the gospel that I have. And to descend up into heaven, leaving captivity captive, so he
God at the right hand of the Father, and to send back the Holy Ghost unto you. Am I right? Hallelujah. That's why he said, don't let your heart be troubled. And you know, don't start tripping. Amen. Hallelujah. Hey, don't start tripping. Am I right? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Guard your heart. Notice what he said. Let not your heart be troubled. Read.
Believe in God.
Now, notice he said, you believe in God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Now, notice he used the word believing in God. And that's because in your heart is where you believe. Amen. It's in your heart where you believe that he is. That he's able to do exceeding and abundant. Am I right? In your heart, where your belief system is where you make decisions. Amen? When people truly repent, they repent based on the decision that they made in their heart to make changes. Folks that come out, I'm going to fuss a little bit now. Folks that come out, turn all the call, woo-hooing and crying, thank you, Lord, and then they get praying, go back and do the same thing. They ain't really repentant. They just felt sorry for what they've done. And what the key is, they haven't changed their belief system. But people that come and get saved, they change their belief system. And you know, they make changes only in believing that what I was doing was wrong. Now I believe that there's a better way.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Come on here, somebody. There's a better way. And that way is Jesus. Thank you, Lord. So those that they don't even have to come up and shed a tear. Come on, I'm going to say this. People who truly repent, they don't have to shed a tear. But their true repentance evidence is in their changed belief. They change their action. They change what they do. Amen? Did you do that? Y'all didn't do that? When y'all came to Jesus, y'all didn't change your actions?
Yes,
you didn't change the way you were living?
Yes,
in other words, you changed your belief. You believed that other way was wrong. You said you begged God. Begged you. Amen? Hallelujah. Notice what Jesus said. He said, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God. Do what?
Believe also in me.
Read.
When my Father's house.
Amen. He's telling you what heaven looks like. In my Father's house are many dwelling places. Amen. And how many of you want to see your dwelling place? I want to see my mansion.
Yes.
Amen. How many of you really want to see your mansion?
Oh, yeah.
I want my address to be 200 Glory Lane. Thank you. Hallelujah. Glory Lane. Thank you. I want to see my mansion. Hallelujah. I want to see it. Amen. I'm living in expectation of seeing it. Are you living in expectation of seeing it? I've been to Pastor Duck's house. Her house is spotless and clean. Hallelujah. I can't wait to see a match. Hallelujah. My God, it's going to be spotless. It's going to be clean. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And if I match, I'm going to put stuff up that I like. Hey, hallelujah.
talking, but I looked at the reverend and I thought he had a man cave. Amen. I said, I'm going to get me one. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. You know, and I'm going to get off to a course here for a minute. You know, when David killed Goliath, y'all know he chopped off his head.
Yes.
Thank God he took that head back to his tent in my own mind for a trophy. I believe he put a spear in the ground and put the head on top of it. Hey! Hallelujah. So that, you know, when things get tough, you can look over at that trophy. Amen. See what God has done. Amen. You got to look back and see what God has done. You got to look back at your testimonies and see what God has done, where God has brought you from. When you're rolling down in a zigzag, thank you, Lord, and they got all the voice when they and lost that victory, lost that family, and they wanted to kill him. I believe how he encouraged himself to look back at his victory. Hallelujah. That's what caused you to encourage yourself. You got to look back at your victory. Amen. Hallelujah. In my mansion, I'm going to have me a victory for you. Hallelujah. Yeah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. My God in heaven. All right, what's he say? In my Father's house are many mansions. Now, notice what he said. If it were not so, I would have what?
I would have told.
So, Jesus is saying here, verily, 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 I say unto you. Amen? Jesus is saying. Thank you, Lord. You know that in him, there's no God. Amen? In him, there's no life. It's impossible for him to lie. All right? Thank you, Lord. So whatever Jesus said, it got to come to pass. Whatever Jesus said, it has to be true. Am I right? How many of y'all believe that? Amen. How many of y'all know that? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. He's a friend that sticketh closer than a brother. He's a friend that loveth at all times. Am I right? Hallelujah. So Jesus said, if it were not so, I would not have told you. Read. I would have told you.
I go.
Now notice what he said. I go
to prepare a place
for who? For you. Huh? Yes, we use that general term for us. Amen. I'm talking today about living in expectation. I know Jesus got a prepared place for me. You know Jesus got a prepared place for you. Hallelujah. 200 glory reign. Could you stop by when you get to your place? I'll come to your place. Amen. Hallelujah. Read. What did he say? I'll come to your mansion. Hallelujah. Read.
And if I go prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself where I am.
Yeah.
And he may be
on. Now see that? That's living in expectation. Amen?
Yeah.
Ain't no time now to be feeling silly. Ain't no time now to let the devil trick you. Amen? Don't let the deceiver get you. Am I right? Don't get so caught up with stuff down here that it makes you lose your hope up there.
Yeah.
Amen? Hallelujah. Because all this going to burn up.
Yeah.
And all this going to be done with me.
Yeah.
Amen? Ain't that the word of God? There's going to be a new heaven. That's newer.
Yeah.
Hey, coming now from heaven.
Yeah.
Come on here, somebody. Yeah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Ah, my life. Thank you, Lord. So don't get caught up with the stuff down here. Get caught up in the work of the Lord. Amen? Hallelujah. People bend the street. I got to bring that back. People will be
speaking.
People will talk about you.
Yes.
Am I right?
Yes.
The enemy will attack you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. But don't give up.
Okay.
Don't throw in the towel. Amen? Yes. Hallelujah. You got to be vigilant. Am I right?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Let's look at another thing that Jesus said. Drop down to verse 18. Here, he's talking. John 14:18.
I will not leave you, prophetess.
Uh-huh.
I will come to you.
Now, he's talking about the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Lord. He said, I'm not going to leave you comfortless. Amen? When we see these things happening to us, I said earlier when I was there that we should not lose hope. Things that are going on in the world today, in the news, I'm going to be honest, I hate it, but I stopped watching the news as much as I had been. Huh? Wait a minute. I'm going to be honest. Can I be honest? That's easy. Not that I want to see bad things happen to people, but when that mother report came out and they didn't die nothing, I'm like, what? After everything being said, and after everything that's been going on, I said there's a dead cat on the line. Your testing through your trial. that these things don't overtake you and cause you to want to throw in the towel. Amen? People are throwing in the towel nowadays. They ain't got no company. I got a call this morning. A probation officer I work with committed suicide. Killed himself. Kind of family trouble. First thing I thought about it, we needed to come. We need God. Amen? When you got God, we can all be on the brink of wanting a check out of you. But there's something about the Holy Ghost. There's something about the love of God that constrains us, that encourages us. God, you'll never find it in the Word of God where God is telling you to give up. God will always tell you to hang on in there. Wait on the Lord. He'll tell you how to be a good courage. He said, I will strengthen thy heart. Yeah. All you got to do is wait. Hallelujah. Thank you.
Thank you,
Jesus. Thank God for the Holy Ghost. Thank God for the anointing. Thank God for the Word of God. Thank God for prayer. Amen. Prayer helps you. Amen. Prayer helps you to get an understanding about what's going on. And the Holy Ghost makes intercession when you pray. Hallelujah. With groanings and moanings that cannot be uttered. It strengthens you. Hallelujah. Telling you to go ahead. Amen. Telling you to be encouraged. Telling you to be strong in the Lord. Amen. Because Jesus is soon to come. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. So these, when we see these things happening, we gotta be encouraged. Don't lose heart. Amen. Don't lose hope. Never think that God is never in control. Amen. Why? Because He's already prophesied to us that these things must be. What we see going on in the world right now, it has to happen. Amen. But while you see it happen, what does He tell you to do? Look up. Your redemption draw nigh. Amen. Hallelujah. It is expectation. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Go into St. John chapter 16, verse 22. We're still talking about what Jesus said. Hallelujah. 16:22. I like this verse too. Thank you, Lord. Jesus talking to me. You got to take this thing, aren't you? That's the Lord. Read, God.
And now, therefore, have sorrow.
Yes.
I will see you again.
And look what he said. I'll see you again. I'm going to show up. You may sorrow now, but I'll see you again. Now you may have heartache now, but I'll see you again. You may have some pain now, but I'll see you again. That's him. He said, I will let nothing separate me and you from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. I'll see you again. Amen? Then he said,
amen.
He said, I'll see you again.
Amen.
You may be sorrowful. Don't let your heart be troubled. Don't be afraid. I'll see you again. Who said that? Jesus said it. Thank you.
And your heart shall be sore.
Come on here. That's heavy.
Yeah.
He's going to cause your heart to be sore. In fact, He's going to take you through a process. You ain't got no more tears, no more pain, and no more heartache. Hallelujah. Y'all with me? Y'all believe that?
Yeah.
Thank you. Now, this is what you got to take with you while you're going. and he's going. Amen? Not every exercise is in the house. Amen. Your whole body say shut down. Stop moving. You're going too fast. Hold on. I'm going to fall apart on you. But as you keep persevering, you keep on moving, you start loosening up, you forget about all that. Up. That's the same way with the Lord. You got to keep moving. Hey, you never keep it moving. Ain't no, don't sit down. You burn down. Ain't no, keep it moving. Amen? And notice what he said. He said, I'm going to cause your heart to flutter. Now, my own mind. All right, well, let me get this for a second. He's in it now. I got him now. He hooked. but just think about it for a minute. I can think about what can make me happy. But Jesus knows what can really make me happy and blow my mind. Jesus knows what can make you happy and blow your mind. I can't wait to see him. Hallelujah. What he got in store. Oh, eyes have not seen. No ears have heard what the Lord has prepared for. I read up.
Your joy, no man.
But read that again.
Your joy, no man.
Thank you. I'm you. Amen. Ain't that beautiful? Hallelujah. That's when we get that song, Pastor Reed, when we say, this joy that I have, the world can't take it. No, the world can give it, and the world can't what? Take it away. Ain't that something? Thank you, Lord. Think about what you're going through right now. That ain't nothing compared to what the Lord has in store. Just be steadfast. Just be unmovable. Amen. Just hold on. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Let's go over then. I'm going to show you what Paul said. 1 Thessalonians, chapter number 3. This is part of our Sunday school lesson. First Thessalonians chapter number 3. Verse 13. I like this verse. I really do. It also gives me some hope about Christ. I read up.
Right to this end?
To this end?
You may establish your heart.
Now, he wants you to establish your heart.
Unblameable.
Don't let your heart be troubled. Don't trip. Amen? Root and ground your heart in Jesus and his return. Amen? That he's going to give you something. That he won't leave you coming. He'll give you a joy and a peace. That passes all grief. What's he say?
To this end, you can establish your heart from blameable and holiness.
And what? Holiness.
Before God.
Hallelujah. Man, I want to live.
Yeah.
I love holiness. Amen. Why? Without the witch, no man shall what? See the law. Holiness. Go ahead up. Wait a minute. What is holiness? Righteousness. Separate. Amen? Hallelujah. That should be our calling card.
Yeah.
Only.
Yeah.
Amen? What does holiness look like? Wow. It looks like peace. It's like soul. It's like righteousness. Amen. It looks God. Hallelujah. Thank you. Hallelujah. When you look at people, you see it all.
Yes, sir.
See holiness. See righteousness. See the way. You got to see the way. What's it look like to you?
They don't believe it.
loving somebody that got something. Because if you don't receive it, and you try to go out, you ain't got nothing. Because you ain't received it. You follow what I'm saying? So you gotta be put in you. Now, because you gotta believe what you believe. You follow?